This video discusses the new IFC Schema Filtering capability of ARCHICAD. The Map IFC Types for Export dialog is where we can map ARCHICAD classification entries to IFC types and IFC type products. With a classification entry selected on the left, we can click the IFC Type button, which displays the IFC entity structure, from which we can select the IFC entity we wish to map the classification entry to. ARCHICAD now supports both the IFC 2x3 and IFC 4 schemas, but the two schemas do not have the same IFC entity structure. To help in mapping to the correct IFC entities, a new IFC Schema Filter field is introduced in the dialog above the IFC Type panel. Let us see an example of how it works. We want to map the furniture classification, so it is selected on the left. We click the IFC Type selection button. The IFC entity structure appears. If the Show IFC Entities for IFC 2x3 Schema option is selected in the IFC Schema Filter field, only entities compatible with that schema may be selected from the IFC entity structure, while incompatible entities will be grayed and may not be selected. In this case, we can select the IFC Furnishing element. If the Show IFC Entities for IFC 4 Schema option is selected in the IFC Schema Filter field, the IFC Furnishing element is now grayed in the IFC Entity structure, and it is not compatible with the IFC 4 Schema. A yellow warning icon is displayed to the left of the IFC Type button, indicating that the selection should be corrected to make it compatible with the IFC schema selected in the IFC Schema Filter field. Additionally, yellow warning icons are displayed to the left of the furniture classification entry, plus all its parent entries up the classification hierarchy, which gives a quick visual clue on which classification entries' mappings need to be corrected. To solve this, we can map the furniture classification to either the IFC Furniture or the IFC System Furniture element entities, both of which are IFC 4 compatible and can be selected from the IFC entity structure. If the Show All IFC Entities option is selected in the IFC Schema Filter field, any IFC entity may be selected from the IFC entity structure. We may want to use this option when we do not aim to be compatible with one or the other IFC schemas. At the same time, this is when we might select an entity that is not compatible with the IFC schema we plan to use it with. Thus, the recommended workflow is to select the IFC schema we plan to map for, then map all classification entries and resolve any mapping warnings the dialog displays. When all mappings are corrected so they are compatible with the IFC schema selected in the IFC Schema Filter field, no warning icons will be displayed in either side of the dialog. A gray warning icon may appear to the left of either the predefined type fields if a predefined type was selected that does not exist in the schema selected in the IFC Schema Filter field. This informs us that the value will not be exported because it does not exist in that IFC schema. For example, the covering classification is mapped to the IFC covering IFC type and molding predefined type. If we now set the IFC Schema Filter to IFC 2x3, the gray warning icon appears since the molding predefined type does not exist in IFC 2x3. Let us select the not defined value to correct it, and the gray warning icons disappear. ARCHICAD also introduces the ability to specify the value for user-defined IFC types and IFC type products. Let us see an example of it in action. Let us select the slab classification on the left. In the IFC type predefined type field, select the User-Defined value. The User-Defined Type field below becomes enabled. Let us type Flat Roof into the field to specify its value. During the IFC export, this User-Defined value will also be exported. The last addition to this dialog is the Synchronize Predefined Type Values When Possible checkbox. When it is checked, the Predefined Type and User-Defined Type fields of the IFC Type product will be grayed, so they may not be modified, and they will inherit the values of the IFC Type's corresponding fields, so the values are always synchronized. The checkbox is checked by default as these fields are usually set to the same value for both IFC Type and IFC Type product. The other dialog to incorporate the IFC Schema Filter field is the Map IFC Properties for Export dialog. The IFC entity structure shown in the dialog is based on the IFC4 schema, just like in all other IFC dialogs in ARCHICAD 23. Only IFC entities existing in the schema selected in the IFC Schema Filter field will be displayed in the IFC entity structure, unless they are the parent of another IFC entity that does exist in that schema. For example, if the Filter by IFC 2x3 schema option is selected, the IFC Furnishing Element IFC entity is displayed, as it exists in IFC 2x3. While its child entities IFC Furniture and IFC System Furniture Element are not displayed, since they exist in IFC 4 only. In case of the Filter by IFC 4 Schema option, IFC Furniture and IFC System Furniture Element are displayed, since they exist in IFC 4. Although IFC 4 Furnishing Element does not exist in IFC 4, it is displayed since it is the parent of the other two IFC entities, and its display is needed to show the correct hierarchy leading to its child entities. Finally, in case of the Show All IFC Entities option, all IFC entities existing in either IFC 2x3 or IFC 4 are displayed.